plants that are okay to eat, but don't eat any of the berries that are white on the tree, those you don't eat. But there's trailing blackberries around here, there's a food garden and a medicine garden in the back that we encourage people to visit as well, as you would like. The work here that we do at the Longhouse is sort of twofold. It's a gathering space for people from all different programs, all different parts of the college, and it's something that everybody at the college likes to use. Our program is one of the other public service centers here, and what we do is we support native arts and cultures. And we do that through artists in residence, giving grants directly to native artists, and having events and programming throughout the year in the Longhouse. And one of the things that if you want to be a part of that program and you're nearby or you're going to come back and visit in Olympia, is you can like us on Facebook for Evergreen Longhouse. And so everything that we do, all of our programs, we try to publish there as well. The Longhouse is the first building of its kind built on a U.S. college campus. So many college campuses now have longhouses or indigenous design buildings. We were the very first in the U.S. to have a building of this style. And it was built not directly by the college. There were lots of supporters in the college, including our past president, Les Hurst. But the college came about very much because of grassroots efforts. We wouldn't be sitting here in this space if it hadn't been for the hard work of many people from many different tribes in the region. And so the space that you're sitting in was thought about and designed by who we call our pillars of the Longhouse. In particular, Pauline Hilaire, Hazel Pete, Bruce Miller, Vi Hilbert, and David Whitehair were our key figures who helped imagine what this space would be like and how it would be used over the years. And the room that you're sitting in right now is very special. It's the part of the Longhouse that's the most traditional. So if a family or a community were to build a Longhouse in this region of the country, it would be shaped pretty much like this, with the bench seating around the perimeter of the room and then the important fire pit in the center. The screens that you see against the wall were woven by Bruce Miller, and they tell two really important stories. The one here on the left is the creation story of the Macaw tribe from the NA, and it talks about how the Thunderbird saved the people from starvation by bringing them a whale. And then on the right is the story of the Tawana or Skokomish people, and it talks about how it's important for people to hang on to their language so that they can hang on to their culture. Bruce used cedar and dyed part of it with hemlock to get the different colors that you see on the background, and then the paints themselves are all natural paints. So he used a special mud dye, moss, he used red alder and salmon eggs to get the colors that you see there. And one of his, and he did this in 1995, so this is, it's never been retouched then. And one of the things that he said was that those paints would last longer than any kind of commercial acrylic paint or oil paint that you can buy in the store. So we encourage you to look around at the artwork. There's artwork across the hall in the building as well, by many of our friends. Students at Evergreen helped design the pieces that you see on the grates for the fire pit as well. And if you have any questions while you're here, if we're in the office around, you can come in and ask us. And during the day, the carvers are in the carving studio here, and they're working on our second art studio, which is a weaving studio, a fiber arts studio. And it's going to have Maori elements on one side and Salish elements on the other side. So we're hoping to open that in 2017. I know that's a real quick rundown of what we do, but I don't want to take up too much of your schedule. The cedar shakes and the beads in this are from an old model longhouse that was at the called the Sea Monster House. And so when we were building the